fire works really, really well on them.
Oh, really? They're forcing me to come all the way back here. There we go. Sweet! 3 high potions. Woo! Oh, this is a freaking save point. Okay. Really?
Yeah, I love this game so much.
Is this strictly, like, really focused on map uncovering?
It's just a bonus. I mean, you really don't have to do it, of course, but it's a nice bonus that they added to this version of the game.
Well, I mean, it seems like if I would uncover all of the map, like, come endgame, it's really worth it, either for items or possibly gear.
Yeah, you get a lot of nice extra stuff from it. I mean, I don't... Like, as you get towards the endgame, I don't really know, how good the stuff you get is. Because I never actually finished this version of it, despite the fact that I love this game. But it's something I need to do.
Okay. Well, I don't mind trying to do that as we go through the game. Because, I mean, you can end up going to every area when you get brought to the place the first time anyway. And I'm pretty sure I won't get 100% map completion because of the very first area, and I don't feel like going back through it right now.
Oh, and, the Mist Cave?
Huh?
The Mist Cave?
Yeah, the Mist Cave. I don't think I got 100%. I think on one map I have 98% or something.
Well, there was only one map for the Mist Cave, but yeah, I mean, once you get your airship, I mean, you wind up back in Baron at some point anyway, so...
Okay. This is actually going really well. 2 healers and 2 really heavy damage dealers. Like, even the fact that the heals are, like, minuscule at best, but it's, like, so worth it, even if you spammed mana attacks.
Yeah, it's really helpful. Especially since Edwards is a constant HP regen. Ooh, hold on, I got a cutscene of 14, be right back.
Okay. Yes, auto battle. What is that?
I'm back, bitches.
Oh shit, run.
Hide the women, hide the children. Hey, Zwoozy, I was your 11th follower on Twitch. Zwoozy?
I was talking, but I didn't have the thing on. I said I'm GameKey's biggest fan, though. I'm sorry.
That's alright, I'm his biggest troll mod.
This is probably true.
Zwoozy, it's really weird. Like, putting it into perspective, the idea is that, basically... Plants' social network is ridiculous, and he has his own ways of finding things out. So, he's been extremely supportive of mine and Brickbro's channels at the moment. So, being the biggest troll mod, I think is kind of just in his nature for what he can and can't do. Or I should say, lack of what he can't do.
Make me famous, bitches.
That's what we're trying to do.
Yeah, but I'm pretty.
You're Freddy.
I'm pretty.
I can't make anyone famous right now. I'm not even like a big guy. I'm just like a no name out there right now.
Are you calling me fat then? Huh?
Fat?
Yeah. Saying I'm big? Huh?
I am so confused right now.
Don't worry about it. Nah, you're helping me enough. Don't worry.
Hey, like, guys in chat, like, even though if you guys are even here and still awake, like, the biggest thing about me and the channel is if you guys are learning to stream for the first time, I will gladly help you. If you guys need tips, I will gladly share everything I know. It's literally just putting the work into streaming and doing. That's what makes the channel. And eventually, you just come into your own. And you just become like yourself. You find your own little style and way of doing things. And, you know, being amped up here during the day is what I do best. Other times, you know, when it becomes evening, I have, you know, it's cool, it's laid back, chill, you know, everyone can talk about whatever. And that's, it's like two different ways of looking at the stream in reality. However, I do refer my friends. Blood Crow is the big XSplit guy that I know. We've been good friends, and he is in the same boat as myself in style when it comes to helping out others. He knows XSplit, I know OBS. What he has learned about XSplit, he will gladly impart on you guys as viewers. It's awesome. And then we have a huge, huge list between all of our friends and other broadcasters that, you know, I host myself. You know, the friends that come here in on the channel, like the great Zwoozy here, Scott Plants, he's a good friend. Then you have Leah Justice, Effie Grim Reaper, Blood Crow, you know, Virus60, who's hosting us. Like, these guys are all streamers in their own right. Scott Plants is just a big supporter of streamers. He will glad, you
I'm
know.
I'm a reformed streamer.
Yeah, he's.
I got off the addiction.
Oh, you got off the addiction?
Yeah, I got off the smack, baby. I couldn't handle that Twitch smack.
Oh, he couldn't handle the Twitch smack.
Why'd you stop?
The area came, the time period in Twitch when a lot of people started doing face cams and stuff like that, and you really couldn't be too popular unless you had a face cam. And I started losing viewers because I didn't have a face cam, and I really have a face built for radio. So I just found it was probably just better that I might hang up my mic. And I moved on to things like podcasting and stuff like that instead, so.
Oh, come on, man. I've seen uglier guys on freaking Twitch than what you probably look like.
See, there's a reason you don't know what I look like.
I think you're beautiful no matter what they say. Words fall to you now.
And people like Swoozy are the reason I left. There's a lot of crazy
stuff.
Yes!
Make him laugh.
Yeah, there's just too many crazies out there for me at times where it was just like, and I, you know, it's easier for me to be the bully and tell people to F off than it is for me to try to be the streamer and be the nice guy and, you know, stuff like that, so.
You're hired.
That's why I make a really good bully. Troll mod, but I'd probably make a poor streamer.
No, I don't, you wouldn't make a poor streamer. You, at this point, you'd probably be like the bike man, you know, or the me jash. Like he'd be one of those streamers who could honestly, over time, would make it because of the quick wit and the witty commentary for gameplay. Like, that's just the way Scott Plants is. Like, you know, not only that, but he can immediately react to things in chat when he's looking at it and just like come up with the craziest stuff to say, which is awesome. That's definitely why I like you know when I talk to you about things that I'm going through, you know, here on the channel or problems I'm dealing with, like with the desktop, you give me another perspective on how I should do things, and it helps me out as an individual because I can handle these situations a little better because not only is it just me, but your input allows me to make an adjustment to what I did before. So I don't have to worry about this situation again.
I just love you.
It's one of those things, guys. It's like when you start streaming, you want as many contacts as you can have. And like I've told everyone before, You're only limited by your social networking skills. So if you don't have a Facebook, get a Facebook. If you don't have a Twitter, get a Twitter. Get an Instagram, a Vine, a Chive. You know, get all of it. Find anything and get it. And then start, you know, making relationships and friendships with other streamers. You know, get ideas. Start doing stuff together. Like tomorrow, myself, Russ Sloan on Twitch, Roshi666 on Twitch. We have Friday 1111 on Twitch. Like, we're all streamers or broadcasters, and we do stuff together. Russell's bigger than I am, and he invited me to do Rogue Trader, which, for those of you who don't know, is a Dungeons & Dragons-style tabletop game, but we're playing it. It's in the world of Warhammer 40K on stream using the website Roll20. And it's pretty cool because we get to all get a piece of the action in the role-playing aspect. It's something different for all of us together, and we can do these compilations of viewers and come up with a crazy broadcast. It's awesome.
That's so cool.
And I would have honestly, if I would have been approached back in May before school let out, and I would have been told, hey, you're going to be doing something with Russ Loam, you're going to be playing a tabletop game on stream, I would have laughed about it. I was like, no, that ain't real. People aren't doing that. And then I stumbled upon a bunch of these deep Dungeons & Dragons streams. It was pretty cool.
That's awesome.
But it's also, Lying Doorknocker, what's up, man? Basically, it's like,
Lying Doorknocker?
Yeah, Lying Doorknocker. He came in through Russ Loam's stream, as mentioned before. Russ Loam's a cool dude. And the fact that, it's through the community that I find out about these guys. Scott Plants has been huge on like, just picking people when I say, hey, community,
what's
guys.
This?
Pick a game or a streamer.
That's a monk of Fabul.
Here we go.
Well, that's because I've watched a whole lot of streams on Twitch. And I'm hooked in with a bunch of different communities. Instead of being kind of locked into one, I know a lot of different streamers at different levels.
Oh! Oh my god.
There are a lot of people who are in GameCube situation, who are kind of just getting started, just starting to see some real growth. And then there are other ones that I found that, you know, that I've become friends with that are really big streamers.
He's talking about me when he comes really big.
Considering I'm your 11th follower? Yeah.
Yeah.
And just how to market it, because that's one thing I learned when I was doing my own streaming, was how to market, how to get people to find you. Because unfortunately, there are a lot of streamers on Twitch. When I first started streaming, there weren't nearly as many people streaming as there are now. And as we get more and more people streaming, it kind of dilutes.
That's no ordinary crow.
And it's harder and harder to grow. Where I think it was much easier when I first started streaming, it was much easier to grow an audience. Now, with so many people out there who have systems capable of streaming, who have the cams and everything else, and can get access to all the latest games, it's just a different market now. I think it's harder to make it as a partner now than it was even just a couple years ago, because you've got more streamers and the same amount of audience. I couldn't believe when I first started doing it that people would actually want to sit there and watch someone else play video games. And I think it goes back to, at least in my generation when we were younger, that most of the games we played were single player games. We very rarely played multiplayer games because they just weren't out there. And so now, you know, you were so used to having to sit there and watch your friend take his turn, and then you get to take your turn, and that's how we took, you know, that's how we played the game. I think now, you know, with all these multiplayer games and stuff like that, there's still that element of the stress-free of enjoying somebody playing a video game and not having to make the decisions, not having the stress of worrying about, oh my God, I'm going to die or whatever else.
Why isn't that big?
You know, in this, I think that really does change. That's what drives the audiences on Twitch, that people are just looking for a stress-free way to enjoy video games. Well, and they can sit there and they can make fun of you, you know, if you fuck up. They love to be able to talk shit, you know, and make fun of you for getting wrecked and shit like that.
Get wrecked.
Well, there's one other thing that I see, too, that you didn't touch on, but I think is a portion of the audience is one, it's a way for people to check out a game without having to fork out the $60 for it. Or it's also a way for some people to enjoy the story of a game by watching somebody else play through it when they themselves actually can't afford the game.
Yeah, but they can. I mean, there are demos out there where people can try it, and with torrents and stuff like that, more and more people can get access to games without buying them. But I think there is a portion of people who want to see or get tips and tricks. I watch the streamers play Ark, just so I can, maybe there's something I didn't know about Ark that I can find out about, that, oh, geez, you can do this, you can do that. I didn't know you can do that. You know, that definitely adds to it. You know, I've learned a couple of things playing Ark that I didn't realize that you could do as part of the game. But it's, you know, it still blows me away, and I don't think anyone's really put their finger on exactly how to do it, because you look at some people, you know, not to call anybody out, but Co Carnage, not the most attractive guy in the world, who's got a huge following. Not what you would expect. Not some guy on Madison Avenue would look at and say, oh, this is the perfect face for a gaming company. That guy's got advertisers like Intel and shit like that. I mean, that's crazy. Never would I expect that, you know, somebody like that. But it's really, you know, personality is a big driver in this whole thing, too. You have the personality to be a streamer.
Yeah.
Because you really do have to have, you know, a positive attitude, friendly, fun.
Holy
people that want to sit there and watch you play a video game.
Yeah, and I would actually look up to Co Carnage and some of these bigger guys. Like my big three that I watch is Co Carnage, Tangent Gaming, and Burke Black. What actually attracted me to their channels was that their chat community, their chat, not only was it active, but they were extremely supportive of each other and new viewers. And it was like, if the rules were broken, moderators that were like loyal to the channel were like, hey, don't do that. This is your warning. And people like understood, okay, not to do that. That's okay, fine. And then what was also another big deal was that like it was just extremely welcoming. I felt very welcome, and I loved that feeling, and I want to give that to new viewers here. I want people to feel welcome. And not only that, but again, hey, you think about streaming or want to start streaming? Hey, the advice is here. I'll do it live. I'll walk you through the setup live while I'm streaming. That's not a big deal.
What's this? Clad like that? That's a monk of Fabul.
And That's really what I loved about their community, and I still watch them even when I'm not streaming. Why? Because they always have new ideas, or they're discussing tips on streaming, or how to be better, or just, hey, don't give up. You may be not streaming today, or you may not have a lot of viewers today, but there's always tomorrow. And just to keep working at it, you're gonna get better. You're gonna fall into your own, you know, knack at streaming. You're gonna become your own thing just by constantly doing it. And that's and a funny story is I started streaming and I didn't think about it for about 2 weeks on how I talk to people. And then my friends kind of laughed at me when I started talking. When we finally got to hang out and meet up, I actually started talking to them at the table. You know, it's like five other people, as if I was broadcasting my show, and I realized it's just out of force of habit. I'm constantly doing it all the time. And it's only because I love doing this. It's a passion I have for video games and, you know, streaming. It's like the level up to video gaming. You know, I get like a high from it, is what I would call it.
Okay, you're gonna have to stop then, because drugs are bad.
Okay.
Like emotional,
Yeah, Genki, don't auto battle and use Yang's kick attack.
Remember, stay in school, kids. And do drugs. Not do drugs.
Oh, wait, I should turn it into a pig, huh?
No, that won't work.
Stay in drugs and don't do school. Work.
Exactly. Stay with drugs, but don't do school.
I didn't want to let my schooling interfere with my education.
Yeah, I didn't want... Yeah. What?
That's an actual quote from Mark Twain. I don't want to let my schooling interfere with my education. I've learned more from video games than I probably have learned through all of my years of school, including college.
See, I've played a lot of League. Well, honestly, just recently I stopped only playing League and Minecraft. But, it really, like, heightened my senses and stuff like that. So that I used to always, you know, be oblivious to the world. Which, don't worry, I still am, guys. I still get pranked and stuff like that, and it's a lot of fun. But now,
what up, Super J-Dog? What's up?
I can actually, like, pay attention now, and it's pretty creepy.
Yeah, you're pretty creepy.
I am pretty creepy, but Scott Plant, it's because I love you.
Yeah, that's what makes you creepy.
It's okay, though.
You're uniquely creepy, so I guess it's alright. If you're copycat creepy, then I'd be like...
You'd be like, what? Come on, lay it on me!
Hey, I'm gonna also get Rosa out of the front row.
At least you're being
unique. She's a squishy mage.
Yeah, I'm about to explode. Oops.
Yeah, when it splits up, use Yang's kick attack.
Kick attack?
It's already split for you. Yeah, he's got a kick attack. It hits all enemies.
Okay, cool.
Wow, that really messed you up.
Hey, that kick attack saved my butt, though. Okay. We'll do this again, dang it.
Yeah, try to set up your party so that Yang will end up in the front row rather than the back row, too. It'll help his damage output and whatnot.
Huh. What did you say?
Yeah, with the way you have your party set up, basically, I would have Cecil be the only one in the front row, and then put Rosa, Iridia, and Edward in the back row. That way, when Yang joins, he'll be in the front row, and he'll do more damage.
Yeah, and I'm sitting here listening now. What's up? Really? Are you getting that mad right now? Really? Wow. So negative. I see. It's every other spot is the back row, and then the two in-betweens are the front row. Got it.
Or vice versa, yeah. It's like endgame, you'll probably have three people in the front row and only two in the back, but for now, you've got a lot of squishies.
I don't have a bow for Rosa. Because I thought we were doing it with Iridia. And Iridia couldn't equip a bow, so I just said screw it altogether.
Don't worry about it too much.
Third time's a charm, guys.
You're mostly going to want to use her to heal and stuff. That's a monk of Fabul. Don't worry about a bow at the moment.
Yeah, and that's fine. This monk is pretty sweet, though.
Yeah, he's pretty badass.
Like, looking at this, I already if I could do it, I would be a monk like that.
What's the crystal for in,
What's the who now?
What's crystal for in Ark?
It's like a replacement for glass. The spyglass uses it. The scope attachment uses it. You need it for, like, your refrigerators and stuff like that. It's for higher end crafting.
That's no ordinary foe. Oh man, we need to help.
Yeah, that kick attack ends that first fight a lot faster.
I'll use Gang's Brace ability? Got it. Windless Scroll, how are you? I'm gonna focus as much as I possibly can with him. Couldn't analyze? What?
Yeah, and use Rosa to try and keep everybody's HP as full as possible. It's a boss, that's why the Libra didn't work.
Yeah, and that's what I figured. Prayer unanswered.
Yeah, that's why I never rely on it when it's absolutely needed. And you can have everybody else guard, too. Of course, I'm saying this as it's probably already exploded.
Oh, crap! I put him on darkness instead of defend.
Be right back.
Okay.
Hey.
Oh, well, that ended it. Oh my god, one kick, and that was that. Three or four rounds of focus. Wow. You have my deepest gratitude. I am Yang, Grand Master of the Monks of Fabul. Yang, Monk Grand Master.
Oh, nice. Yeah, him being in the front row helps with the damage on that.
We came here for training and found death instead. A great host of monsters waylaid us. I am the only one who survived. My monks were fine, strong men, but even they could do little. We're on our way to Fabul.
A man named Galdez has taken control of Baron and is using his forces to seize the world's crystals.
And you think he intends to come for a wind crystal as well?
Yes, and soon. He has already taken the fire crystal from Damsian. Fabul will be next.
And our monks slain the castle is all but undefended. The few who remain in Fabul lack proper training. We would have no hope of fending off a strike from Baron were it to come now.
The monsters that beset you were most likely set by Colbert's as well.
To eliminate and leave Fabul defenseless.
If that is true, he may be moving against your kingdom as we speak. We must hurry. We'll aid you in whatever way we can.
I am grateful for the offer, but there is no reason for you to be dragged any further into this.
Our stake in this conflict is no less than yours. I am the Prince of Damsium. Rosa and I are barren, and this child here lost all she knew because I allowed this enemy to deceive me.
I see. Then I will most humbly accept whatever help you are willing to provide.
Come then. Time is our enemy.
Fabul lies east beyond the mountains. We'll go at once.
The monk Yang joined the party. Sweet!
That's right, everyone got killed. Duh.
Rest in peace, my fallen brothers. I will see to your family's safety.
I'm a traveler. I just noticed that.
So what is up, guys? Man, that took us 3 rounds to defeat that boss. 3 rounds. Ouch, 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 and more ouch. I think I should set kick as the auto battle command.
Yeah, that's what I did, I think.
Life's Anthem!
Nice. Oh, wow. That is really nice. Oh. Okay, I'll take that Life's Anthem. That is a nice way to go about it. Heck yeah.
Now this was one of the first games where the actual story and characters really drew me in.
I like the music though. The music is awesome. I feel like I really screwed up earlier today though, guys. Because if I would have stayed streaming and not had that little hiccup in the beginning, I know we would still have way more people here. However, the folks that are here, I thank you for being here and having a good time just as much as I am. It's just one of those downfalls is myself as a streamer. And I'll admit it. I screwed up for myself.
How'd you screw up?
If you were here earlier, you basically heard all the commotion in the background. A lot of dumb stuff.
A lot of dumb stuff? I love dumb stuff.
Yeah, we'll just go with that.
Nice coverage, man.
Let's see.
Can you train a plant? Or, not a plant, Scott. Piranha?
I don't know. Is Plant still here?
I've heard that you can, and I've heard that you can't. I haven't tried it myself. I only kill him.
I think everything is tameable to an extent.
The fishies are not the or aren't.
Ooh, bomb cores.
Coral or coel or whatever.
We've been having issues with the Titan boa, the snake. We have, as admins on the server, we can force tame it, and it will work. We have knocked them out, and it. The only problem is like because you can't use narco on them.
Mm-hmm. A lot of stones.
Yeah, stones, basically, it's slingshot fists. We were able to knock them out. You get access to the inventory, and it turns into a tamed animal immediately, but you can't get access into the inventory to feed it or anything, and it won't follow you around.
Hmm.
Oh, and it won't follow you around?
No. Doja did it when he was down in the caves.
Huh, that's crazy.
Oh, so GameKey, there is something about Final Fantasy IV that it's kind of annoying in a way, but there are three summons you can get in the game that are random drops from enemies.
Hmm? Really? That's kind of cool.
Kind of, and kind of not. Like the cockatrice that you're fighting now, or...
Oh, you meant that game, not Ark.
Yeah.
No, yeah, not Ark, sorry.
I was confused.
Oh, fair enough. But no, the cockatrices, you can get... They drop a summon. The basic... I forget if they call them imps or goblins in this version of it. But those can drop one, and the bombs can drop one. But it's completely random. Any of that enemy family throughout the entire game have a minute chance to drop them, but they are obtainable. But it's kind of one of those things that you only get if you absolutely positively must have everything in the game.
The three summons are goblin, bombs, and tentacle monsters. Tentacle monster. So I basically get one of them.
It's not tentacle monster, it's cockatrice. It's the flying birds that turn you to stone.
Oh, and that's considered the summon? I think I'm on the right path. Or do I need to go all the way north?
No, you kind of rotate around, but you'll get there.
Okay.
That's a bad Super J-Dog for seeing tentacle monsters. That would be way cooler than the cockatrices.
Oh, yeah, no, right? He pretty much knows this. He's from Australia, so... Also, at the same time, I don't know if the game could be different for Australian users, because there's a lot of games that Australia, being the strictest country on the planet, I'm actually curious if they modify some of their games.
Okay, well, I'm pretty sure that Australia would be less likely to get a tentacle monster than a mythical bird that turns things to stone, you know?
Yeah.
I really don't think Australia is all that restrictive, to be honest with you.
No, like, in comparison to America and Britain and Germany, they actually have the strictest ESRB code, and their board is basically like, hey, Manhunt came out. Nope, you can't have it. It's extremely too violent. Oh, Grand Theft Auto is questionable, and they didn't, like, release Grand Theft Auto for, like, a little while everyone else had it on the planet.
Well, if you've ever been to a bar in Australia, I can tell you they're not one of the strictest countries. Yes. Oof.
No, just when it comes to video games, that's where the only way that they're really restricted.
Yeah, like, video games is kind of a big deal over there. Like, they restrict a lot. In the video game world.
And opals. But that's a different subject.
Oh, opals? Yeah. Yeah, usually the DS versions of these ported games, there is a change between the DS and the Steam versions. Like in Steam, they mentioned that the legendary Smith had other items besides the same ones from the DS version, but also there were like one or two other minute changes that were also only brought to the Steam version of the game. So I'm figuring, okay, well, they made some changes just for Steam because it was the absolute last remake of it. No big deal. But the main storyline is still there. It's just like little perks for being a computer game now, basically.
Well, I think some of those changes were made in iOS and Android versions, too.
Yeah, and originally, those changes are brought about because of the DS having the Wi-Fi feature, the online feature. Basically, even though these games are offline, like Final Fantasy III, the guide I found and Googling basically stated that some of your missions, you were technically just using your mailing system to send out data, or receive data, to basically fake, okay, I sent a message and then received one, you know, X amount of time later. And it used your internet connection for that.
Yeah, the mod version of it required Wi-Fi.
Yeah, and because of that, they actually made the adjustment to the Steam version. They actually tore down anything that related to Wi-Fi and just brought it into the Steam game. So the game itself would take care of it, and you wouldn't have to have the internet in order to get those features.
Right, yeah. And there were also some things that that you used the touch screen for on the DS and stuff, so they obviously had to change some of that.
Yeah, so like Super JSON said, like, you know, they made the adjustment for Steam that it's the cockatrice, but in the DS it is the tentacle monster, which is just the difference between those two, far as we know for now.
Within the Super Nintendo version, so, I mean, if... And I'm pretty sure that was in the DS version in the States, at least.
Who knows?
They didn't like the word cunt.
Probably not.
They enjoy the word cunt in Australia, but maybe they don't like the word cock.
That's funny, yeah.
Quick question. Super J-Dog, while you are looking stuff up, is there a difference between... Final Fantasy IV on Steam and Final Fantasy IV on the DS. Is there like any major changes or improvements to the Steam version? I would like to know that directly due to the fact that it's something that won't be mentioned, you know, as you play through the game. You'll just have to figure it out or find it. Wow, that kick. That kick. Wow, like 500 damage. Jeez.
I'd be curious to know that stuff as well, honestly.
I don't care.
I found it. Babul Castle. Mr. Yang, you have returned. His Royal Highness awaits you. Oh, Lord. Oh no.
You should save before you get too far into Fibble Castle, by the way.
Oh, okay. I'm going out right now to save.
Yeah, that's one thing with this game, you should always save before you go into a city, town, castle, or such thing. Because things happen sometimes.
Yeah, and I learned my lesson in 3. This one kind of seems to be giving me a continue spot. That's why I didn't think about saving. Is there anything special here?
You.
Define special.
Like, is there any items that I can find that are only here at this very moment kind of items?
There was an item shop and a weapon shop.
Hey, I found the weapon shop.
Okay, that would be good. I would buy stuff there. Because I think there's some stuff for Cecil. At least there was in the Super NES version.
Whoa, they want 3,000. I don't know, should I buy one of each claw?
No, I wouldn't buy one of each, because you can only equip two. And you will get more specialized ones later on, but I would get one for sure.
Okay, so buy one or two.
Well, he should have one equipped already, so I would just buy one that is not the same as the one that he has currently equipped.
Oh, okay. He didn't have any equipped. Whoa.
Oh, really? Well, that might be. See, this is coming across with some of the changes, because I believe originally in the Super NES one, he came with a fire claw or an ice claw equipped.
Vic Voyager, how are you? What is going on, my friend? Many things have been changed, like instead of the village catching fire, it gets caught on fire. It gets caught on fire and monsters kill people, and Kane and Cecil just watch it. Yeah. I watched that. I was like, what? Whoa. Yeah. Which one? Oh, is that the one here that's gonna give you issues? You're gonna have keloids? Huh? Aww. Choice FX, what's up, man? Vic Voyager, hiya. Maybe the spider was trying to get the gnat. Now, here's a question. If I change out my gear with Rosa and I go from a staff to a bow, does she lose the ability to use her magic?
No, she'll always have the magic. Much money on Rosa.
I'm actually selling.
Well, it's useful gear no matter what, but you know.
Spend some money on her, take her to a movie. Buy her dinner.
Buy her a pretty dress.
Who?
Rosa. I disagree. I think you should spend a little money on her. make her feel special.
Wow, that's it. There is nothing for her. Oh. Oh, dear God. Oh, I could have put the ice staff on her. Crap. That's what I get. I'm a complete jackass.
Wait, what?
I sold my spare ice staff.
Doji, I love you.
Gotta go to bed.
Hey, what's up, buddy?
All right, Super J Dog, you have a good night, bro.
The egg thing for taming is—it's not true. It doesn't do shit.
Really?
Yeah, eggs don't do jack.
Yeah.
None of this Bronto.
The amount that they're eating.
No.
What did you test it with, the Bronto?
Yeah.
Take all
unless
the gear from Rosa.
The only thing I can see is if it changes it, and then you can take it out afterwards, and it stays working or something, but.
You can always test that by testing the taming
well,
first
we're gonna test
and then
that
changing
now, yeah.
It. Yeah. Because they have to have some use other than breeding, because they wouldn't put them in the game since they're not putting breeding until later.
You can eat them, and they give back a bunch of, they give you a bunch of food, but that's about it right now.
You can't even eat them straight. You have to cook them, don't you? I've never even tried to eat any of the eggs.
No, you can eat. You can just eat them.
Huh.
I thought you said that they worked for dodo birds.
That is what I saw on the YouTube video, that basically somebody placed a dodo egg inside of a dodo bird and it basically insta-tamed.
I found that a T-Rex eats faster.
That's what we thought, but I just tested on this Bronto. And if it did change it, it did it right when, like when I first put it on it, but I can take it off now and it's eating just as fast with it on it or without.
Did you guys, summon it, or did you guys actually tame it?
No, I'm doing my own real tame. He's testing it again.
What am I doing now?
He's testing to see if it works off for it. Like, if you just put it on it one time, it works, and then you can take it off. But it doesn't make a difference.
That was when I realized
it on or off now.
I wonder if maybe the addition of our multiplier that we have on things right now might affect that. Maybe it's not noticeable because there's already a 2x multiplier in. And
no, you'd be able to notice by just the number of the food that's dropping.
Living Wave became Recording Wave, the journalist.
The number of food that's dropping the same with or without the egg on it.
Yeah, we should test it without the egg in it and then put it in the egg and then see if there's a difference.
That's what we did.
Oh, I thought you said you guys did it and put it in.
I didn't notice off rip. I didn't. Like it might work like when you first put it on there, it might automatically make it start eating faster and stay that way. That's what he's testing now.
Okay.
To see if it drops slower and then you put it in and it works and you can take it out. But as of now, without me testing it that way and already been taming, it doesn't change.
Well, shit, if it doesn't work, I'm getting those eggs out of my fridge.
This is freaking awesome. You can look
like
at previous cinematics.
Yeah, there's not really any clear use for them right now besides just eating them and...
Where is
they
the noble knight, the man who took me in as an orphan, and raised
that
me
sucks.
As his own?
I was hopeful for that.
Oh, that's
true. And I heard, like, way back in the day, you could put an egg in a female and it'll, you know, breed an ant, breed
worth
a dinosaur, which is, I guess that's what they plan
robbing
on doing with them later for the whole breeding thing,
by
but
right. What
I don't
need
know.
Could be so great?
Well, what's up, Genki? How's it going in
King's
Final Fantasy?
What about me?
Not bad, man.
There's no forgiving what we've done.
I just found the theater system. So I'm literally rewatching a cutscene.
Won't you tell me what happened? First you're sent off to
Sidia. Oh yeah, we can go back and watch the cutscenes.
And now to hunt some beast.
Hell yeah,
so
this is cool.
Did something happen to
Sidia? Oh, GameKey, I found what he meant by technical monster. I
no,
did totally forget one summon that drops.
Then why won't you look at me?
It's a mind player.
In Mysidia,
it's a what?
It's a mind player. You know, they have the tentacle face.
Ah, gotcha.
Worn this darkened armor for so
I totally
now.
Forgot about that one.
There's
yeah,
no
so he was right,
me.
And I was right. We were both forgetting one.
Not even in my heart.
You're a good man, Cecil.
I'm a coward. A coward who cannot even defy orders he knows he ought not follow.
Cecil of the Red Wings is many things, but he is no coward. Not the Cecil who I love. The king is sending you to Mist to slay the Eidolon, isn't he? If anything were to happen to you, I couldn't...
Kane will be with me. I'll be fine. It's late. You should get some rest.
Be careful.
Thank you, Rosa. But I know what I've become.
Who sleeps in heavy plate armor? Seriously.
I would.
Apparently you don't live in the city anymore.
Shit, when I lived in Detroit, I used to sleep in goddamn freaking ballistic.
But that's not heavy plate, that's...
Still pretty much close enough.
In the winter, I sleep in heavy pajamas. Does that count?
Sure, why not?
Alright, cool.
Hey, GameKey, did you see Super J-Dog's last comment before he logged off?
Yeah, by the way, take all the gear from Rosa. Is she about to leave the party, I'm guessing?
Yeah.
Aw, spoilers! I'm watching this for entertainment value. Like you just told me Sansa got raped.
I just watched that episode today, by the way. That's how caught up we are.
Yeah, you can't rape the willing.
You didn't look very willing. My wife says that's a horrible way to end an episode.
Really?
Well, that's the last scene right there at the end of the episode. She's like, oh, what a horrible way to end.
What show?
Game of Thrones. We just finally watched episode 6 of the season, finally. The one where Sansa Stark gets raped by, what the fuck is his name?
Ramsay Bolton.
Well, okay.
Well, they're married, so, but, I'm assuming she was willing. And it's just weird. Well, like, Reek stay in the room was kind of really...
Like she like, what? Like they're good. Like the guy's good, but the wife is bad.
No, the wife is good. The husband is very, very evil. He flays people who he doesn't like, which means peeling the skin off their bodies.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's kind of a nasty dude, and she was kind of forced in a way to marry him. I mean, it was her own choice. She could have ran, but
I think she wants to get revenge.
But it's their wedding night.
Your Highness, I return with urgent news. A man known as Gorobez is coming from Windcrest.
The servant used to be a noble, who he had tortured into...
What?
Basically, a slave named Reek.
These people before you came to warn us.
I'd read the books and I was like, wait. No, this is all wrong.
Yeah, because Sansa never ends up there.
Your Highness, there is no time for introductions. Your castle must be secured.
Who's the person with red hair?
Aria,
Your armor would have you for one of Baron's own.
No, Arya wasn't there. Arya was already at the house.
Why should I trust you?
But the imposter that they told him it was Arya Stark.
No. They told him it was Sansa because it was a red-haired girl.
I fought for my own life when they came upon me. They could have
just some red-haired girl from the north that they grabbed and said this was Sansa.
I assure you, your enemy will not wait to shoot you. Please, you must believe us.
Yeah, I think that was her real name. That's what threw me off right away, is I don't remember her marrying a Bolton. What the fuck? That's not for me, but I know that they're going to start definitely having to.
It has been many a day.
Carve their own storyline now that they're very close to catching up to where the books are. The next book's not coming out until next year, so.
How far is that?
They already passed the book in a lot of places.
It has fallen.
In some places.
The fire is ours no more. I lost my mother and father, even my beloved Anna. Tell me you will not let your own life suffer
alert.
The same fate as ours.
Yeah, okay.
Forgive me, but I only found it hard to believe you spoke the truth, but it seemed you knew. Still, without monks, there is really nothing to do. You aid us in our defense.
They went so far off the damn book of the books on that damn show.
These men have both strength and courage. By your leave, I would have them stand with me on the front line of our defense.
They went so freaking far off.
If that is your wish, I will trust to your judgment. Might you two ladies assist our healers?
Shouldn't even have fucking happened yet.
My kingdom fate.
In the first couple of
my
seasons,
kingdom
they
fate
ran,
then is
they
in your hands.
Stayed really close to the books,
Your Highness.
There really wasn't a whole lot of variance from the books in the first couple, and it hasn't been until recently that we've seen some big variances from the book this season more than anything else.
Be careful.
But,
I will.
He's trying to push off.
Rydia,
you know,
keep Rosa safe.
He takes so long to write the books, and it's going to be a while until we see another one.
Well, yeah, the show's
she's gonna get kidnapped
book
or
seven
killed.
Ever possibly could come out.
Yeah.
Enemies.
So an interview I heard with him, I think it was on the Nerdist. They're talking like end of 2016 for the next book. But by then, the show would have already been shot and put out. But he is also EPing on it too,
Charge.
So he does have some dumb writing control within the show.
Yeah. I mean, he's already told them the general story on how it was supposed to go, so they'll get to the same general ending at least. The journey might be a lot
nice.
Different, but the end result will be about the same.
Sweet. The Red Wings.
Anyone want to place any wagers on what they think the end is going to be? Who actually wins the Iron
there's
Throne?
There's finally going to be a
John
fucking
Snow.
Dragon.
We'll die
there's
like
finally
going to
be a
here.
Fucking dragon.
Retreat to
oh, there have been dragons. You apparently haven't been watching.
I haven't watched the current season, no.
Yes.
Or the last,
well,
or even,
there have been
wow,
the
he
last half
of
last season.
Forgive me, I've drawn you into
a
hopeless
now.
Fight.
Since the end of season one, actually.
Yeah.
I told you before, this
that's
fight is as much as
it showed up
at
the end of season one.
And it isn't lost yet.
It's been a while, man. I guess, yeah.
They're breaking through.
Yeah, I think the last time I watched anything was like halfway through season one. And
yeah, yeah, so you haven't seen dragons or the naked Daenerys yet?
No.
So that's worth watching just right there. As far as I'm concerned.
True that.
Kick! Boom! Taking them out.
No, I know my general theory is not
ooh,
real
Edward
popular
nice.
Or supported at the moment just due to things.
Well, yeah. Like, yeah. I think I know, even though I'm not as far into the season, I have read some stuff. And
we cannot hold them here. Fall back.
It would be hard to believe your theory. Or subscribe to your theory, I should say.
Holy crap.
Yeah, I wanted Daenerys until like this
isn't
season.
The throne
to see
just
a little
upstairs?
Bit of crazy come on her now.
It's all
like,
right. The king is taken a cover elsewhere with the women and children. We need only draw the enemy here.
The look in her eyes when, you know, she,
and crush
she's done
them.
Some of the things that she's done. It's like you can tell there's some crazy there.
Oh yeah. And
believe me, I can spot crazy in a woman pretty quickly.
No, my general thought, honestly, I mean, I've kind of had this thought since way, way, way early in the series. So I mean, it's not like even a spoiler of anything to come. But I honestly think that Jon Snow is not Ned's son. I think he is Ned's sister's son with the Targaryen.
There's no place for us to make a stand.
But, you know, Ned didn't want to reveal that he was Targaryen because Robert would have wanted to kill him because he was, you know, an actual heir to the Targaryen throne. So he took him back, said he was his bastard.
I locked
so
the door.
I think Jon's actually Targaryen.
I think it's going to be
where's the crystal?
Just with his special powers.
In the
I think
chamber
it's gonna be somebody
of
out of the family from the north.
Well, yeah. That was kind of weird that they. Bran wasn't even in a single episode this season, I don't think.
Nope. What are you doing?
Not that I saw.
Of course, even in the last book, I think he had chapters in the entire book, so I guess that's not that big a thing.
Yeah, he just seems to be on a very difficult journey.
Not to mention the other kid, Raikon. He hasn't been heard of since, like, the third book at all.
Yeah. I don't even know where he is right now.
No, I know. He went off with Osha, and that was, like, the end of that, and there's been no word of him since.
Yeah, and he has more of a claim to the throne than Bran does, because he's older.
No, Raikon's youngest. He was, 3 years old, and Bran was 5 in the books, anyway. I forget how old they are on the show.
It looked to me like Bran was younger in the show. That's why I was...
Wow. Seems like Cecil is straight up just, like, first attack. Jeez.
I just remember
how... There are too many of them.
The last book.
No choice. We'll make our last stand
with Daenerys' situation.
Really? How long is this fighting going
to
take?
Yeah, it took the entire book for her to do Edward. Something interesting. It was amazing.
Yeah.
When I was reading the last book, every time I hit a Daenerys chapter, I'd stop reading for like 2 weeks.
Okay. Good night. I'll see you upstairs soon. I love you.
In my heart, I have support for her because, in all, I think she's the most legitimate heir to the throne because of her family and her background.
Are you sure it's not just because Emilia Clarke is really hot?
Well, that plays a part in it too, but even when I was just reading the books,
that
it was
time,
a rebellion that kicked her father out. The family comes from Volantis.
Kane, you're alive.
You know,
I am.
I think they possess special powers, you know, especially the control of the dragons and stuff like that. Now that there are dragons back, it's kind of like a symbol that
the
family
is
regenerating in a way, bringing back the old culture of the dragon.
What do you mean?
She's been, especially early on, all the trials that she had gone through, it just kind of led me to believe that she was going to be the one to do it. But I think the Starks have been through just as much and probably have a more legitimate claim because of their control of the North. And
I want to
especially with all the drama
questions.
That's going to be coming to the North very shortly, that's going to be a big center of attention.
And he jumps.
But that family's been nearly wiped out.
Yeah, it's going to be really interesting. I'm still really, really curious on how it's going to end and where it's going to go.
It'll be interesting to see if... And I know he's getting a little bit more advanced in age, and he takes him so long to fucking write the books. More stories within that universe. You know how Star Wars has a lot of fan fiction, and they have a lot of books that are canon within the universe that weren't necessarily written...
Well, not anymore, but yes.
Like the Jedi Academy series?
Yeah, just kind of that kind of stuff that, you know...
It all was canon until Disney bought Lucasfilm out.
Yeah, and now you don't know what's canon and what's not anymore. Disney doesn't believe in canons. It's violence.
Yeah, God. I get you, though.
Kane! Even you now?
Even if J.K. Rowling is writing a series of books now that are going to take place within the Harry Potter universe. But not necessarily, Harry Potter books.
Yeah, from what I understand, the first one was supposed to take place before the events of Harry Potter.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how those go through.
I couldn't read those books for one reason. I had to get them in audiobooks. I couldn't read them. I don't know what it is. Usually I'm a good book reader. I'm just going to go to the audiobooks. You know, it's probably because I was doing a lot of driving at the time when my wife first got the books. And
Golbez is freaking huge.
The usurper.
And told me, you have to, kept talking about it. You have to read this. You have to read this.
To give you something fair enough.
That's probably why I did it. But I tried reading the books, but we already had them in the house, and I just grabbed up and tried to read it. This one was keeping my attention, and I just felt like the audiobook moved faster. And it's all just read. It's not even abridged. It's
an unabridged version of the book. the dude that did the new read the Harry Potter books did such a great job with voices for everybody and whatnot. Yeah. I mean, Professor McGonagall sounded just like the chick who actually played her in the movies. It was great.
Let it be.
Oh, and she's one of the worst characters in that whole series. I hated her.
Oh, fair enough. It was just an example.
Yeah, but yeah, that's the one I'm a huge fan of at least that character.
But, speaking of like, you know, epic long book series and or authors that take forever to write books. Did you read any of the Kingkiller books by Patrick Rothfuss?
That's it. Nope. That big guy.
You would seem your life is spared.
He's got two of the three books out now. Wait. And, you know, the second one came out, I think, just before
the last
Song of Ice and Fire book. And I've been wondering very seriously who would get the next book out, if it would be Rothfuss or Martin. And oddly, it actually looks like it's going to be Martin before Rothfuss.
Well, I think Martin's got a little bit more pressure on him. He's hot right now, and you don't want to lose that.
Are you all right?
You know, so if he, you know, strike while the iron's hot,
thank
you.
Get
some more of those books out. But now they have a ton of them right now because there are people who really want to read them.
Well, I honestly think that the Kingkiller books are way better than A Song of Ice and Fire. Honestly.
Yeah, but they don't have the. They don't
What's wrong with you? They took Rosa, but hey, they didn't hurt her.
The TV show.
We just need to rush
the marketing tools that
and the crystal.
Yeah. Right now.
We can take it back too.
I'd read that somebody optioned.
She's right.
The Kingkiller books.
It's my turn to help.
But you know, actually, I want to say it was Showtime that did it.
Think of a way we
But I would love to see those done as a show too. But
you.
I mean, that last book really needs to come out.
Sweet. Well, we came across the big guy.
We stopped spoiling.
Huh?
Are they done spoiling Game of Thrones?
We were pretty careful about what we were saying. We didn't spoil it.
I haven't made it.
I mean, the last book came out like 4 years ago, or 5 years ago now, and the show ended like, what, a month ago now already?
No, I'm not sure. I'm only on episode 6 myself, so...
I know, but I mean, but it aired like a month ago. I mean, can you really call it spoilers at that point? I mean, people have had enough time.
Oh, people! You can start talking about Clerks right now. People will bitch about spoilers.
Yeah.
20+ years ago. If you haven't seen it, it's new to you, right?
I'd like to find somebody bitching about a spoiler for Clerks. That'd be funny.
Well, hey, you know Dante was supposed to die in the end, right?
Oh yeah, I know. I've seen that ending. It was on
it may
the
still be dangerous
disc,
outside
actually.
The castle. Will you not stay?
Well, I mean, it's on the newer DVD releases, but it was on the Laserdisc release before it came out on DVD.
Oh, big Kevin Smith fan myself. Listen to all the podcasts every day.
I actually saw a recording.
Oh, they're forcing
James
me
Bob
to
get
stay.
Old live. It was pretty sweet.
They're forcing me. They want my money. What?
I did too, and I bought the VIP passes so you can go back to the meet and greet.
Oh, nice. See, my friend and I actually only found out about this one like the day that it was happening, and it was a 3-hour drive to get to it, so we were honestly lucky to get tickets at all.
No, my wife has a thing for Kevin Smith. Any guy that can make her laugh. She kind of gets crushes on relatively quickly, and she loved Clerks. In fact, she never really heard of him until we got married and I showed her Clerks.
You must be exhausted, Master Yang.
Which was
by
one of
all
my
means,
favorite
rest here.
Movies
like.
In college. Shows you how old I am. And she loved that one, and I started showing her the rest of the
if
series
we
with
Gomez,
you know,
we need
Dogma and Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back and Chase Amy and Jersey
is
Girl.
There no way we can enter the kingdom.
You know, she really loved it,
the
and
Red
then I said, "Oh, you know, he's got a podcast."
And
she never even knew
power.
A podcast.
Its maritime forces are relative.
But turned around to podcasts and his.
We go,
and
we go.
She works from home, and likes to have stuff running in the background that she can hear.
To lend us one on the
all of a sudden, she became a huge podcast.
Much for
it. For those podcasts she wanted
to
listen to.
Such a simple plea. Thank you.
Right. that whole network of stuff.
That Dragoon, like,
I'm a big Tom Steve Dave family, so.
His name is Kane.
When they can get an episode out, because they seem to have problems getting episodes out on time.
We'd sworn to fight Baron.
But that's one that I listen to on a regular basis. Hollywood Babylon, too, with Kevin Smith and Ralph Garman.
Oh, I love Hollywood Babylon.
We should rest.
They actually have a community behind the TV show.
Yeah, I know. I heard about
Cecil
that.
Cecil is,
like,
just getting torn apart,
guys. It was good to go, and I actually haven't had a
chance. I will see that
the
ship is ready for
like
you.
Like the last
delay.
Bits where...
Gang, you will go
I think the last I heard
is
actually still happening, but never
no
found out what happened
such
to
a
it.
Sacrifice as you have made.
Yeah,
young
they
Lord
did
Baron,
shoot a pilot for
you
it.
You defended my people selflessly and lost Lady Rosa for it. Please, I want you to have this sword. It belonged to a Dark Knight
but they were
who once
waiting
visited
to hear back
from consider it a token of my thanks for your valiant efforts.
Yeah, so it's Paul Flanagan, who's the guy who runs the store, Kevin Smith owns it, Brian Johnson, who's the big bearded guy. It also includes Brian Quinn from Impractical Jokers. Brian Quinn actually worked for Kevin Smith for the longest time before he got the Impractical Jokers show. He was actually an intern at Smodcast Studios and stuff like that. It was on Tell Him Steve
when you've made ready,
but he had that comedy troupe, the Tenderloins, for the longest time before that on Staten Island. And all of a sudden, they got that show on Practical Jokers on True TV.
Such as it has never
and
known.
So he's had a TV show now for, I think they're going on like their fourth or fifth season. And occasionally they bring in Ming, who's from Comic Book Men as well.
Do not fear,
but yeah,
for his highness. He was a monk before he was a king.
My
and
regular
a strapping
thing.
One of
it comes
that.
Out. Usually I will listen to it the day it comes out.
Okay, lady.
But probably on my podcast player, 40 different podcasts that I listen to. And that's because I drive all over the state of Wisconsin and Northern Illinois for work, so a lot of time in the car gives you a reason to plug your audio device. That's something other than music for a while.
Oh, yeah, I totally get that. I used to have a job where that was basically kind of glorified data entry kind of thing. But so I used to listen to them as they came out. You know, when I was doing that job, because I could do it while I worked, but now I actually I manage a store now, so I don't really have time for that.
Would you like to
see
me dance?
So I'm way behind on my podcast, because I was only listening to Hollywood Babylon and Nerdist, but I had a huge backlog of Nerdist, and I just never got caught up.
Oh, Hardwick just pumps out those episodes like crazy.
Oh, I know, it's like,
two or three a week.
Yeah, two or three of those a week. He, you know, is hosting at midnight every week, and, you know, he finds time to tour and do stand-up stuff. So I don't know how that man exists.
And start an improv school at his own theater in the back of his comic store. You know, it's like, all right, dude.
What?
How about a vacation?
I'm so lost.
Like, I don't know where he sleeps. Oh, have you seen his girlfriend? She's
want to start training to be a monk, too.
Oh, I've heard... I've never seen a picture of her, but I have heard him use her name and stuff like that. But
it's a blessing that our homes are within the castle.
He went from Chloe Dykstra,
they without,
who is
they would have no doubt been destroyed.
To this girl he's dating now, who is actually probably even more so. And it's just ridiculous. That guy, seriously.
Oh, another a relatively new podcast I've been listening to. It's Gareth Reynolds and Dave Anthony. They do it. It's called The Dollop. It's an American history podcast where they kind of pick a particular story from history, and Dave Anthony tells the story to Gareth Reynolds, and they react to it. And it's usually something a little crazy, you know, a little wild. And that's a fun one to listen to. I think Gareth Reynolds is hilarious.
Yeah, right on. Yeah, I honestly wish I had more time to listen to podcasts. I need to start trying to make some time to. Just get caught up on Babylon, if nothing else.
Yeah, I tend to listen while I'm playing video games. Or driving around. Like,
how did I know?
If I'm not sitting in TeamSpeak listening to people in TeamSpeak, like, I'll get aggravated with the stupid questions coming out of TeamSpeak. I hop up into my own little channel and kind of hide there. And I'll put on a podcast and listen to it. And that way, if anyone needs me, they can come find me. But other than that, I don't have to listen to the, you know...
Ooh, how many hits of my pterodactyl are killing four swords?
Three.
Yeah, well, that's the kind of answers I'm giving now. I'm giving absolutely stupid answers to stupid questions.
Well, it's like three. That's how many licks it takes to get
questions
to the center.
Or you get a stupid answer.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, it's like, yeah. Just by what you said about clerks in college, you got to be around the same age as I am. As I first saw clerks when I was just starting college.
Well, that's why I got the big one of the bigger birthdays coming up here relatively soon.
Which would put you about 3 years older than me then.
Yeah, I think my freshman year in college is the year it came out.
Yeah, I was actually right. In high school when it came out, but I didn't see it until after I graduated.
People, they saved me in Fabul.
Then you have my gratitude, thank you all.
Like, and I believe I was a sophomore the year it came out.
Yeah, and you're unhurt. Of course I'm unhurt. Whose wife do you think I am? A few soldiers tried to bust their way in, but I busted them right back out with my frying pan.
You know, I've actually never seen Jersey Girl. I've always just heard so many terrible things about it that I just never bothered to watch it.
It's actually a really, really, really good movie.
Now you want to know something really funny?
Talks a lot of shit about it, you know, kind of like downplaying.
You are really funny, buddy.
But George Carlin's in it, and right away that's going to make me watch it.
Fair enough.
George Carlin's awesome.
Like Ben Affleck, Jennifer Lopez thing. She gets killed like 15 minutes into it, so you don't have to deal with a whole lot of her. And what's her name?
The lead from Aerosmith, his daughter.
Dang it, not that route.
Oh, well, that's why I never watched that movie. I fucking hate Liv Tyler.
Oh, I have. Oh, I'd leave my wife for Liv Tyler.
I'd be tempted to stab her. I seriously hate her. I think she's a horrible actress. I just can't
Did
stand
I seriously
her.
Just do a big circle?
Oh, I've got such a crush on that girl. It's the dark hair that gets
the hell,
me.
Like...
I'm really into brunettes and... Especially when she dresses
so
up
confused.
Like an elf. At that point, I'm just... It's over.
See, she was the worst thing about Lord of the Rings to me.
And she's actually the reason that... Oh, I shouldn't say she's the reason I watched it, because I read the books, and I would have probably wanted to see it just because I read the books, but... Yeah, I think... Yeah, she's the cat's meow.
Well, fair enough. Yeah.
Different strokes for different folks.
Exactly.
And I'd stroke it all day to her. But Carlin in it is great. He just...
Well, Carlin's just great, period.
Yeah, but in that movie, he... I don't even know how to explain it, but yeah, he brings something extra in that movie.
Oh, God. So this just popped into my head, thinking about Kevin Smith movies that, that a lot of people either didn't like or didn't see or didn't realize were his or whatever.
Play it on the...
Zack and Mary make a porno.
Yep.
Elizabeth Banks, played, was in
this
that.
Game is for
yep.
And I was watching an old episode of Law and Order SVU, right? And she was in it.
Ugh.
And it came out in the episode that she was doing porn to, make money. Ugh. And the dude who was her husband in that movie was, Mark Paul Gosselaar, played Zach in Saved by the Bell.
Yeah.
And just the fact... And he was also doing porn in this episode. So that just that tenuous strain of, her doing porn and Zach.
It's like, hey guys, I
just
see
made
you
me
all.
Laugh.
Well, that movie flopped.
I wish you
the
best.
Smith,
this
pot.
Has been an amazing time.
That was a great movie. Though. I love it.
If any
I thought
of
it was good. I mean, it was a flop.
Feel free to mention
really
it in
the
chat.
To having issues with advertisers
have a good time.
Wanting to carry... The stick
hey,
figure
guys,
sex positions.
Do you That's guys want to raid before we end the stream? Do you guys want to select our first host for the night? I mean, I have a lot of folks to choose from. A lot.
Let me take a look around and see who I might have.
King G and you, welcome to the channel, man. Welcome.
Who's up?
We are winding down into the end of our stream here. We're actually getting ready
this girl before
to do a raid.
So gross.
All right, she's about the same size as you in the way of viewers and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Okay, I took that the total wrong way until you said viewers.
I know, right?
I'm going to drop her stuff in TeamSpeak, and you can take a look at her game and tell me what you think. I don't know if I've sent you over here before to her.
Yeah, I'm getting ready.
I just asked a question.
What is she playing?
Yeah.
She's playing Final Fantasy.
Coming down.
She's playing Final Fantasy 14. Nice.
Yeah. And so that's one of the reasons that I thought about it. I'm like, oh, that might be a good kind of jump from where we are right now. She's kind of been off for a little while. She had some issues to take care of, but she's finally back streaming again.
It looks good.
So she's lost a little momentum, so throwing a little love her way might not be a bad idea.
I know exactly where she is in the game. How sad is that?
That's pretty sad.
Let's see. Who is this?
Well, you know, Zbuzi is streaming right now. We could always raid him.
Don't raid. It sounds so bad. Why are you saying it like that?
Because that's really what it is, raiding.
The only one I have who's also playing Final Fantasy.
A fellow Burt fan.
Joe doesn't have a face cam, so probably not.
I haven't. I can honestly say I have not seen that person. I need your honest opinion, though, Plants, because I can't physically do it without. I can't load up the page without cutting out on the stream.
Okay, what do you need my honest opinion on?
Well, what do you think?
Whether or not to raid her?
Yeah.
I would do it. She's a great streamer. She'll love it. You'll get a good reaction out of her.
All right, guys. Well, you heard it.
She'll probably even throw some love back at you at some point. So, I mean, she doesn't get a ton of viewers right now, but...
I'll throw all the love back at you. Password.
I'll throw my love all over your face, neck, and chest.
All right, so here's how this is going to work, guys. I'm going to throw the link in the chat. However, there's a rule here. We're going to go into her chat. We're going to go into her channel because I'm going to cut stream. But I will say the signal is the arcade is now open. That will be the signal. And then we'll just spam game raid. And this is how we'll spam the game raid.
A safe place.
This message right here. That will be the game raid. If you have emotes, go for it. If you have, sorts of other streamers' emotes, then do it. Spam those emotes with the game raid. However, if there is a spam blocker, do abide by the spam blocker, please.
All right, I'm
We don't want to harass. You know what I mean? This is all for the fun. It is a good time. So, guys, get over to this streamer's channel. Get over there and wait for the signal. Get over there and wait.
Who's DepScripts?
Get in there and
another
wait.
On the server.
Oh, they took over that island.
All right, guys, it's been
a
lot of fun.
You guys took over.
I'm having fun. I'm getting over there, and I will see you guys tomorrow. But thank you for the host for the evening, guys.
Are they nice people?
No.
Really?
No. In fact, the reason they got all that shit to be able to build that base out there is from raiding other people.
So why don't you kick them?